हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल वेब लर्निंग्स। दिस इज वीरेंद्र कुमार सिंह। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ स्प्रिंग बूट क्रॉड ऑपरेशन विद द माई एसक्यूएल। सो लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द क्रॉड ऑपरेशन विद द रेस्टफुल एपीआई, बट टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन क्रॉड ऑपरेशन विद द थीम लिव एचटीएमएल यूआई। सो let's get started. So let me show you the architecture of projects. So as we have discussed earlier, I have created two portion in this application. One is the REST controller and second is the UI. So in my controller I have create a web controller folder, and inside a web controller I have create one web controller as a controller, and in this web controller I have passed the some endpoint. One is the slash only, it will show the all records, and it is the landing page of my UI. When the request is comes with the slash, it will directly land on the my UI along with the all employee data. So I have create here Hibernate JPA. So let me show the JP folder also. So here you can see, here I am using the CRUD repository, means it's the JPA of the Hibernate, and here I pass the employee. This is the my entity, employee entity. So and employee entity have the some validation. So I have used all these things we had discussed in my last video. So this is the my CRUD repository, and here I annotated the @ repository annotation. This is the stereotypes of annotation, and in service I have used the service annotation, and auto wired my CRUD employee repository inside of employee service IMPL folder, and I have created the some endpoints, like one is the save method, and second is get all method. It will return the all saved employee details, and find by id. Sorry, it's a find by id. Once it get the data using of id, then it will remove the record. So this is the remove delete by id, and one is the find by name and address. So here I have write the custom query. So later video I will explain how to write the custom query according to our requirement. So if you observe here, I have write one custom query. So in later video I will explain about the custom query, and I have created one find by id method. So this is the all my service, and I have created one web controller. In controller I have mapped the my service employee service interface, and using up this interface I am calling the all my services, like get all and update employee, delete employee, delete by id. So all these things here, and for the property file I have added the my SQL configuration along with the ID password, and I'm exposing this application on 8080 port. So this is all about the my configuration. Let me compile it and debug with the UI. So let me build it, Maven install. So you can see here, project built successfully. Let me run it. I'm going to run in debug mode. So let me start in debug mode. Now you can observe here my application is up and running. And one more thing here, friends, I have configured the Swagger to for the documentation purpose. So let me explain about this Swagger. So in Swagger basically used for the documentation. If you have going to create the any RESTful API, so there are the requirement to documentation of that REST API, what data we are need to submit and what response will return by the Swagger. So for this Swagger implementation, I have create one configuration folder, and inside a configuration folder I have annotated some annotations like @ configuration and enable swagger 2, and I have create one class Swagger config. Inside of Swagger config I have created one beans, and this beans I it return the docket documentation type as the Swagger 2, and this is all configuration. And here we need to pass the our controller path. So whatever the project controller path, so in my case there is the com inside of com CRUD with the MySQL. Inside of CRUD with MySQL I have one sub package CRUD with the MySQL, and after that my controller. So I have annotated my path. In later video I will explain in details whatever the Swagger and whatever the properties of Swagger and why the Swagger and all things these things. So let me show the Swagger UI, how it looks like and what is the functionality of. So my you can see here my code is up and running. So for the Swagger purpose, let me hit the Swagger UI. So this is the URL of Swagger UI. This URL is auto localhost 802 slash this is the Swagger URL. So basically Swagger URL is localhost 800 slash Swagger with HTML, Swagger hyphen UI dot HTML. So I have created three controller. So you can observe here it's showing the three controller. One is the employee, second is the user controller, and third is the web controller. So let me click on the any. So how many method you have created inside of that controller, it will show. If you want to perform any task, you can directly hit from here only. And if you want to try, then you can try with the ID. Let me show the ID one, execute. So it will return the your output, because there is no any data. That's why it's showing no record found. So this is the way we create the we use the Swagger. So in my case I'm going to show the web controller, because so in web controller I have created some endpoint here like get, delete by ID here, save and update. So I need to change this method, but because I have used the query parameter, that's why I passed the get method. So this is the all details. So let me show the UI. So if you click the 8080, then it will, I have opened this in debug mode, so it will move in get all, and it will return along with the data on web welcome.html. So let me show my template. Here I have one welcome.html template. In this welcome.html template, let me open this. So in welcome.html I have used the theme lib for the data binding. So I have used the form control here, and a theme lib action, my action is save, and object is employee view. I am going to bind the data with the employee view. If you can observe here, I am using the model attribute here, and my action is the save emp, and object is the employee view. So similarly I have bind here, and if you observe here, I have used the one if method of theme lib. If employee not is equal to null, and so I am using this for the update purpose, because my same UI I am going to save and update both. If data is already there, then it will open in the update mode. If data is not already there, then it will create in insert mode. So if you observe, this is if data is already not is equal to null, means data if not there, then it will open this portion of piece of code till here, if unless means else. So themlib provide the if and unless, there is no else in themlib. So that's why I use the themlib dot unless. If employee is already there, then I need to show the employee ID, employee name, address, DOB, organization name, etc. And also here I am using the themlib for each loop. So this is the themlib for each loop. I get the get body of list, and in this list I get the result data and iterate the each and every data, and so in table format, as you can see here on UI. This is so, let me pass the some data, like I'm going to pass Virendra, Varanasi, DOB, let me show the any data, birth, company name, UG, department, IT. Let me web controller, I'm going to add one here, debugger. So let me hit save it. If you save it, so this data in binding in form view. My machine is little bit slow, that's why I'm not able to see the data in debug mode. So here I create one mapper. Mapper basically convert the my form view data to my entity view. So let me move next. So let me clean it. So it will, I have using the JSON converter here. So JSON converter basically get the data from the UI, it will convert in string format, and after this JSON string convert the my employee view. So now I'm going to save this data in my DB. This is my save method. And after save, it's getting the all response, how many data we have saved. And let me execute one. So you can observe here, there is the one record is inserted. And you can observe here, it's showing the details also, because now it's opening as a update mode. So now we have the data. You can observe here. Now we have the data, because after saving, I have called the get employee, get all records, and binding with the list. Okay. So we have data. So it will open my UI with the update mode, with the whatever the data I have inserted. Let me add the some more data. Name each, Amit, address, test, department is CS. Let me close my debugger here. So you can observe here, one more record inserted. Now I'm going to update my record. So if you want to update the record, let me open the debugger again and remove the some debugger. So I have removed all my debugger. So if now let me click on the first update, once I click update method, then it will show the all records. Let me pass the some data like Delhi, and I'm going to click on the save mode, but let me put the debugger here, update. Because I am in internal implementation, I have put it my ID as a hidden mode. If you observe here, I have added my ID as a hidden mode. So the whatever the feature provided by JPA, if ID is already there in object, then it will automatically update the record, otherwise it will insert. So let me update it. Let me click on the update and I'm going to update Haidali and click on the save. You can observe here, now my address is updated as a Delhi. So for the click, let me delete the record, save also. So if you want to remove the record, click here and you observe here, let me expect this. So I'm using the path variable here, delete slash ID, and if you observe my implementation, so I'm using here as the href html href and update and whatever the instance.id, instance is my variable name, instance.id. So this is the path variable. This is the way how we can pass the my ID with along with the path variable. So let me delete. I'm going to delete ID number first. So I'm clicking, so it will going to delete method. Here is my ID and here employee view. So let me put one more debugger point. So for the deleting any record from the Hibernate JPA or Spring JPA, first we need to find the record using up that ID. If record is exist, then only we can remove the record. We cannot delete the record like delete from table name and ID is equal to this. It will not implement, no such kinds of implementation in Hibernate. It will remove the all details object of that employee. So that's why I find the record of employee. After, if record is present, then only iterate this record using up employee.get, because this is optional. So employee.get method, and once data is fine, then it will employee repository means and delete method. So let me move. So you can observe here, there Virendra is no more. So this is the way we can implement the any CRUD operation with the UI. I'm going to upload this project on the GitHub. Please pull from the GitHub and try from your side. Thanks to watching my YouTube channel. Please subscribe, share and likes. Thanks. In next video, I'm going to explain about the Spring security. Thanks.